Hello, this is Sean Moore, Senior Pastor of Faith Christian Center, and I am back for day three of our Quiet Time with God 7-day challenge. We are admonishing believers over the next 7 days to turn off life's distractions, particularly the television, in order that they can have quiet time with God. So this is day three of our video blog, and I'm sharing just a few quick tips that hopefully will help you and benefit you as you take this 7-day challenge. So on today, I want to just talk with you very briefly about praise and worship. Now, in the book of Revelation, chapter 4, verse 11, the Bible tells us that thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory, honor, and power, for thou hast created all things, and for thy pleasure they are and were created. The Bible tells us that God is worthy. He is worthy, and he deserves to receive our praise and our worship. Now, we praise God for what he's done, but we worship God for who he is. So there are going to be things that God does in your life where you want to lift your hands and you want to give God praise and glory because of his goodness in the land of the living. But understand that thanking God for his acts is one thing, but Moses didn't just know his acts, he also was familiar with his ways. So we worship God for who he is. It was David that said in Psalm 27, verse 4, that it's one thing that I have desired, and that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. Praise and worship is an invitation into intimacy with Almighty God. In John chapter 4, verse 23 and 24, the Bible tells us that God is a spirit, and they that worship God must worship him in spirit and in truth. The Bible tells us that the Father actually seeks for such to worship him. Now, what's so awesome is, as we've been admonished to actually seek the Lord, what's so good is that we're not the only ones that are on the search, but that God is actually out there searching for us as well. Second Chronicles tells us in chapter 16 that the eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth, looking for someone whom he can show himself strong on behalf of, whose heart is perfect towards him. The Bible tells us in Psalms that praise is comely, or praise is attractive to the Lord. It also tells us in Psalms that God inhabits, he invades the praises of his people. And then I like that again in John chapter 4, where the Bible says that the Lord actually seeks for someone that will worship him in spirit and in truth. So, you know, the Bible tells us in Isaiah, to seek the Lord while he may be found, to call upon him while he is near. Well, how do you find a God that you can't see? It's easy. You become a person that he's seeking for. So if you're a true worshiper, you get involved in praise and worship, trust me, you will not be alone for very long. God will invade your space. He will inhabit that time, and you will truly experience the glory of God. I heard it said before, and I've repeated this praise phrase over the years, and that is to praise into a spirit of worship comes, to worship into the glory comes, and then when the glory comes, just stand in the glory. So I admonish you to take time to spend just in praise and in worship, and not asking God maybe for anything, but just in thanksgiving and praise, worshiping God for who he is, praising God for all the things that he's done in your life. And I tell you, you won't be too long before the glory of God will come into your room and you'll sense the very presence of God. And it is the presence of God that transforms us and changes us. So I hope you were blessed today. This is day three of our video blog. And if you'd like more information about the Quiet Time with God 7-day challenge, then just visit us on the web at www.quiettimewithgod.com. This is Sean Moore, and I'm signing off. I'll see you tomorrow. God bless.